next yet?
It's the same as when you asked me 10 seconds ago.
For crying out loud.
What the hell's the matter with you now?
It's taken you forever, and I'm cold.
So sit in the damn car if you're cold.
It's cold in the car, too. Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
You could get done a hell of a lot quicker if you quit nagging me and give me a hand.
I am not nagging you.
Yeah, uh-huh. Well, if you were as good with a wrench as you were with your mouth, we could have this damn thing fixed already.
You are so useless. It's no wonder the army wouldn't take you.
You had to bring that up again, didn't you?
Ethel's husband, Frank, he's a fighter pilot. Margaret's husband, Charlie, he drives a submarine.
I'm warning you.
My husband? Oh, he's a 4F. He works at the grocery store.
You know what? Fix it yourself then, you lousy bitch!
You're in my personal space.
Hey, need a hand?
Sure do. Hope you're better at this thing than my good-for-nothing husband.
There we go. All done. I just needed to, screw a couple things in.
Really? Well, thank you very much, handsome.
Don't mention. Hey, buddy, time's up.
There's a couple idiots here brawling in the street. Copy that.
Straight for a while.
I really can't stay.
Maybe it's cold out.
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. Slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
This evening has been hoping that you dropped in. So very nice.
I'll hold your hand. They're just my kind.
My mother will start to work.
What's your heart?
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
Baby, it's bad out there.
Say, what's in the street?
Have to be.
You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it. This is a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs them.
Release your hold and I will set you free. Monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye and said your story's so touching, sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right.
Here, park right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
Hey, good afternoon. What can I do you for, pal?
My license plate. For you, no problem. There you go. Give her a couple of drinks.
Thanks a lot.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He'll probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss him.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I could see myself in your pants. Now, here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? You be the door and I'll slam you.
Oh, that was bad.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift?
If I wait for a while, it wouldn't be quite fair.
That's Mike's junkyard there. Just drive through the gate.
Cause I haven't tried.